welcome to tonight's recap of The Amazing Race All-Stars.
What an amazing episode.
It was a good episode.
I laughed out loud on this episode. It was so good. I loved it.
All right. Well, they started out in Malaysia and they ended up in Sri Lanka.
Not Sri Lanka.
Come on, people.
In Sri Lanka.
Yes. So their first stop was this temple. And everyone was like, shout out to the Twinnies.
Twinnies. All right. So Brenchel, as everyone knows, has to do a speed bump.
Yeah, because they came in last in the last leg.
All right. So there's a little mishap at the airport here. Brendan and Rachel and Margie and Luke could not get on the same flight with everyone else.
It was full. So they're the two cheeses standing alone, probably Swiss and I'd say
Roquefort.
American.
Maybe. Margie and Luke decided to roll the dice and try and get on standby.
Yeah.
Which the guy was like, I really don't think that's a good idea. You probably shouldn't do that.
Yeah. Brenchel also wanted to be on standby, but then they were like, you know what? We got nothing to lose. We got to go for this. So they went for this 30-minute connection.
35-minute, I think it was.
Through Singapore.
They had a run through the airport. Brendan dropped his bag. I almost crapped my pants because I didn't want them to miss the flight.
Yeah.
And they made it.
I'm amazed that they made it.
That was crazy.
That's incredible.
Margie and Luke, unfortunately, did not get on the standby flight.
Yes,
and they had to wait until the next day.
Quite a while.
Yeah. So Brendan and Rachel
ended up getting
zero
there first.
To hero.
Yeah.
That was crazy.
They arrived at the temple, but it didn't open until 5:45 a.m., so that gave plenty of time for the other teams to get there, except for Margie and Luke.
Right, so everybody's even at this point except for Margie and Luke.
Mm-hmm.
I was so glad that when they went to the temple that they didn't run in there like a-holes.
Yeah.
And they were very respectful. They got their blessing.
Mm-hmm.
They said they got their clue that said, go to the King Coconut Stand by train. And they were all on the same train. Then when they got off, they got in these little tuk-tuks. I think that's what the name of them is. And those people drive like freaking crazy.
They were weaving in and out of traffic. It was insane.
I mean, like right cutting off buses and stuff.
It was
going
like,
the opposite direction.
That like night bus on Harry Potter.
Yeah. Or Mario Kart.
Mario Kart?
Mario Kart.
After that crazy adventure, they arrived at the detour and they could choose between fishing pole or spin control.
The fishing pole thing was really weird. They had to swim out in the water and like climb up on these little stilt seats, and they had a plastic bag from the supermarket.
No.
They had some bait on a string and they actually had to catch fish, and they were really doing it. Those fish were biting because they were hungry.
Yeah, so you put your fish in your bag and go deliver it. Done.
Some of the fish were puny, some were not so puny.
All right, well, it was pretty evenly split with who did what, so let's talk about fishing pole before we moved on. Jessica and John were taking forever to finish this, so they finally decided, we're wasting time.
They made the call.
Let's switch. So they went on to spin control, which a bunch of people did.
Now that was basically a dance while holding these sticks with spinning little drum things
mm-hmm.
on them, which was not very easy.
The dance didn't seem that hard. The hard part was keeping those things spinning.
You know, speak for yourself. Dance would be hard for me because I'm not that coordinated dancing, and then to have to spin something too.
Well, on the scale of dances that they've done on this show,
it was easy.
It was easy.
All right, but the Globetrotters had a real advantage.
They're spinning that stuff on their hands all the time.
For sure. And the dancing was the problem for them, not the spinning.
But they still got it right away. Rachel and Brendan were having an issue.
Big issue.
Brendan was like, sorry, babe. Oh, sorry, bookie.
They really were not freaking out, though, which was cool.
Rachel is the calm one this season. She's like,
it's
okay.
Who would have thunk it? I love it, though. She's going to make a great mom, because I have a feeling they're going to have a baby after this.
Babies! All right. So Rachel and Brendan had to complete their speed bump. So they had to silkscreen 15 t-shirts.
Well, they're in luck because Rachel has silkscreened before and they just sliced and diced their way through this in no time at all. All
right.
So next stop, Trendy Connections Garment Factory. I have experience with this. Yeah, I have. It's a roadblock. You have to sew a shirt and then
they will print the clue
right
on the shirt.
It's pretty easy.
If you've sewn before. Some of these people, they were having issues.
And you know what? I have to say, those commercial machines do go very fast. It's like stepping on the accelerator pedal in a Ferrari. You're gonna go.
All right. Well, they had like an ongoing demonstration for them, mm-hmm. and the shirt was already cut, like in a pattern.
It was a pretty simple shirt. Connor ended up working with Jen. They kind of finished together-ish. The Afghanimals were very entertaining, as usual. I was laughing out loud. They had me on the floor.
It was great.
Flight time friggin' whips out a basketball.
You've been carrying that in your bag the whole time? What the heck?
Where did you get that from?
I don't know, but he was entertaining the workers. It was
awesome.
It's
all part of the show. It was, I wanted to be there. It was so, it looked like so much fun mm-hmm. to be hanging out with these guys.
Yeah, so then the pit stop for this week was Colombo Rowing Club, which is like the premier club.
All right, so Dave and Connor came in first place, and this happened to be the leg that they self-eliminated in their first time mm-hmm. in the race.
Well, this time, they each won $5,000.
Ooh, that's not exciting. Too shabby. Carolyn and Jennifer in second.
I'm really surprised that they're still at the top of the pack, because after they had to beg mm-hmm. for that express pass, I thought for sure that their days were numbered in the race.
They were pretty lame in their season, so.
Yeah. I did not see them doing this well this far into the race, so right. Good for them.
Jet and Cord in third, Leo and Jamal in fourth. Mm-hmm. I'm really liking Jessica and John this go-around. Yeah. I didn't like them in their season, but...
They're so cute together.
They are cute together. Flight Time and Big Easy! What? I freaking love them!
They're so cool.
And, of course, Brenschel.
Yeah, they came in seventh love just Brenschel. In time. Well, just... I don't mean in time, but I right. mean... high up enough that they could make it.
Exactly. Margie and Luke, unfortunately, arrived a lot later. Everyone else.
It was dark.
They tried hard.
Yeah.
I think they've matured a lot in this last section of the race.
I really admire the way that they went through this leg. They knew they were behind. They knew there wasn't really a great chance that they were going to get back into it, but they were really positive the whole leg, so that was good to see.
I respect. I like that. Next time, however, Rachel gets into a little bit of a jam.
She's pushing those little cars around.
What is going on there?
I don't know.
I guess we'll have to wait till next week.
Let us know in the comments what you thought of this episode. Are you sad to see Margie and Luke go?
I think a lot of people will be.
I think, though, this is the third time that they've done the race. Mm-hmm. Like, they're lucky that they've gotten to do this three times. So
I think they've been on an incredible journey, and I think they really appreciate it, so... I see only good things for them in the future. All right, guys. Till next time.
Much love. Edit.